Hi guys! For this video, ang pag-uusapan naman natin is all about sensitivity of bubble tubes. So kung nakakita ka na ng leveling instrument, usually all surveying instruments has a transparent tube na may bubble. Tapos sinesentro natin yung bubble na yon katulad dito para ma-make sure natin that our instrument is perfectly level, okay? So ang tawag natin class sa bubble na yon is a spirit level, no? So the main purpose lang naman ng spirit level is simply ma-make sure natin that our instrument is perfectly horizontal yung side niya. So kapag ganito siya, gitnang gitna, ibig sabihin perfectly leveled siya. Actually, sa karamihan ng mga surveying instrument, especially yung mga leveling instrument, yung pinagkaiba kasi class ng leveling instrument compared to the transit or theodolite or the total station is you cannot rotate the telescope vertically. So the instrument is always steady. Pwede mo lang siyang i-rotate horizontally. So kasi nga ang kailangan lang naman sa leveling ay mga horizontal reading, but you cannot rotate vertically. Okay, hindi mo siya maro-rotate vertically. Naka-steady siya. And usually, it has three, yung instrument na ginamit namin nung college, tatlo yung level niya or tatlo yung spirit level niya. And dapat lahat ng tatlong yon is naka-sentro yung bubble para masabing leveled siya. So, mahirap din yon kasi the first thing you will do is to level the first bubble. Then after nun, you are going to check the remaining two bubbles if they are on the center of each specific spirit level. So kapag hindi, ibabalance mo ulit yung another feet ng nung ating tripod. Then if yung dalawa na balance na, tapos yung isa hindi pa, you need to balance. So kumbaga, that is unrepetitive process until na yung tatlong level nga yon ay perfectly on center. So that is a way para ma-make sure natin na naka-leveled siya. However, of course, surveying instrument, despite its precision, no, our instruments are very precise or are precise compared to their performance during the days, no. But still, we cannot neglect that our instrument can have an error, okay? So, yung error is usually embedded na talaga yan. But, time by time, nai-improve naman natin na mabawasan yung error. But still, we need to consider na there is always an error in measurement, okay? So, here, yung topic sa sensitivity of bubble tube, it considers the movement of the bubble in our spirit level. So, as I said kanina lang, when the bubble is perfectly leveled here, so the horizontal line of sight, or sorry, the line of sight must be horizontal. Okay? However, when the bubble moves either left or right, so pwede siyang mag-move sa kaliwa or pwede siyang mag-move sa kanan, well, the line of sight will be inclined. Okay? So, halimbawa, minove mo itong or nag-move itong bubble natin dito sa rightmost part. This is just an example, no? Kung nag-move siya sa rightmost part, instead na horizontal yung level nyo, so it inclines. Of course, my drawing of the line of sight is exaggeration, no? Kasi nga, napaka-accurate na ng mga instrument natin. Ibig sabihin, hindi na yun ganoon kalaki yung discrepancy. However, yun na nga, in a theoretical sense, magiging inclined siya. Pwedeng inclined pataas, katulad nitong drawing ko, or pwede rin na nasa baba, depending on the situation, no? So, it is just, no, na coincidence na yung inclination niya is yun na nga nasa taas. But, again, it can incline downward. So, the dangerous part of that is, dahil inclined nga siya, ito yung mababasa nyo sa leveling rod. Okay, this part of the leveling rod will be red. Not this one. Kasi ito, this is the true value dahil dyan yung nakatapat kay horizontal. Okay? But, fortunately, we have remedies to that kasi nga, if yung error kasi is hindi na talaga yan matatanggal sa instrument, but we use mathematical concepts para at least ma-consider natin yung error sa computation natin. And ito, yung i-illustrate nitong situation number 4. So, let me read the situation number 4. With the dumpy level, a rod reading of 2.5 meter was observed to a leveling rod which is 100 meters away. So, ibig sabihin class, yung distance dito from the leveling instrument to the leveling rod is 100 meter. So, when the bubble was leveled through 5 spaces through the to the right on a level tube, the reading changed to 2.58 meters. So, that is the problem, no? So, kung perfectly leveled siya, halimbawa lang, kung perfectly leveled, the measurement will be 2.5 meter. Okay? So, kung perfectly leveled. However, nung ginalaw mo yung instrument papuntang kanan and the bubble was moved 5 spaces as indicated to the right, the measurement change naging 2.58 meter siya. Okay, so yun na nga, madidistort yung reading. Sa case natin, tumaas siya kasi nga from 2.5 to 2.58. So, for number 14, the first question is, what is the sensitiveness of the level tube? Number 15 naman is the radius of curvature of the level tube. If each division is 0.6 mm. And number 16, if the bubble is leveled to the left by 3 spaces, what is the rod reading? So, let's focus first in number 14 kasi the question is the sensitiveness. Ang mangyayari, I want you to focus on this triangle, no, na na-form. Ito yung dapat na ma-reading kasi this is the true horizontal, but that is the actual reading dahil nag-incline nga siya. So, for the solution, in number 14, again, focus ourselves in, i-focus natin yung sarili natin doon sa triangle na yon. So, I think, let me solve first for that, no? So, the distance is 100 meter and yung pagbabago or the change of the measurement is 2.55 meter minus 2.5 meter or simply 0.08 meter to. Diba? Kasi nga, ulitin ko, 2.58 meter minus 2.5 meter. And hanapin natin yung angle of inclination or yung pag-incline ng instrument. Let's call that as theta. So, you can just use simple trigonometry here, right? Halimbawa, tangent theta is equal to opposite 0.08 over 100. So, just use your calculator. Kayang-kaya nyo na yan. So, inverse tangent lang yan ng 0.08 over 100. So, in degrees, the answer is 0.0458, so on and so forth, no? Let me show the computation in the calculator, no? Inverse tangent, 0.08 over 100. So, yun. Or, siguro, ang gawin na lang natin is in degree, minute, second. So, just click this one, no? So, 0 degree, 2 minute, 45 seconds, no? So, 0 degree, 2 minutes, 45 seconds. So, we already computed the angle. Kaya lang class, that is not the sensitiveness na hinahanap natin. Kasi, the bubble or the, yes, the bubble moves 5 spaces to the right. So, nag-move siya pa kanan. So, we can say na yung sensitiveness, no? Tawagin tuloy natin siya as alpha, is simply equal to yung na-compute natin na theta over number of spaces. Okay? So, yun yung magiging approach natin sa sensitiveness. Kung nahanap nyo na yung alpha, madali lang yun. So, i-divide yung theta, sorry. The next thing to do is simply divide this by the number of spaces, which is, for our case, 5. Okay? So, 5 siya. And therefore, our alpha is equal to 0 degrees, 2 minutes, 45 seconds over 5, or let me show the calculator work. So ayan na siya, napakaliit niya. Just click again the degree minute second. So 0 degree 0 minute 33 seconds. Okay, so that is the answer. So we can show na 33 seconds ang sagot sa number 14. So, for number 15, find the radius of curvature of the level tube if each division of the level tube is 0.6 mm. So, kumbaga, dito nga sa spirit level, may mga markings yan. And according to the problem, each marking has a distance of 0.6 mm. So, for 15 class, nakalimutan kong numberan no to, no? So, ang gagamitin lang natin sa 15 is yung basic concept ng geometry, which is S, is equal to R theta. Kung naalala nyo to, sa plane geometry, that refers to the length of the arc of a sector. So, this is S, ito yung R, ito yung R, ito yung theta. Diba? So, kumbaga, parang yung S na ito ngayon dito is yung 0.60 mm. Na given. Okay? So, ito lang yung gagamitin natin sa number 15. But take note, kung naalala nyo yung discussion nito sa plane geometry, dapat yung theta is in region only. Okay? Hindi siya pwedeng degrees. Dapat naka-region siya. Nevertheless, the concern of number 15 is to solve for the radius, no? So, here, we can simply substitute 0.6 mm equals R. And yung theta natin is yun na nga. Here, we can simply change na lang na alpha na siya ngayon. Okay? So, instead of theta, we can use na alpha na siya to avoid confusion sa ginagamit natin na symbol. But the concept is simply the same lang. I just change to alpha kasi that is what we note for the sensitivity. So, R, and we can type na 0 degree, 0 minute, 33 seconds, multiplied by pi over 180. You need to multiply that by pi over 180 kasi nga para maging region. So, the radius of curvature, parang ang gagawin nyo lang, 0.6 mm over 0 degree, 0 minute, 33 seconds, tapos pi over 180. This will be in millimeters, of course. So, 3,750.27, no? 3,750.27 mm, or simply 3.75 meters. So, this will be the radius of curvature. Okay? So, for number 15, we can shade letter A as the correct answer. So, for number 16, this is the last part. Basahin ko lang. If the bubble is leveled to the left by 3 spaces, what is the rad reading? So, siguro, i-copy ko na lang itong figure kasi tinatamad na akong mag-drawing for number 16. So, ayun. I-paste natin siya dito. Ayan, pwede na to. So, for number 16 class, ganito yung mangyayari. Yung bubble, instead na nag-move siya sa kanan, nag-move siya ngayon ng tatlong spaces sa kaliwa. Okay? So, therefore, yung bubble natin is moved here. Nandito na siya. And ilagay natin siguro na 3 spaces. So, of course, mababago din yung reading natin. And you need to understand na dahil nag-move siya by left, dapat bumaba na class yung reading. Okay? Sir, bakit naman ganun, no? Kasi kanina, sabi ng problem, nung nag-move siya to the right, tumaas yung reading natin. So, of course, opposite yung left. Therefore, mag-move na siya this time pababa. Okay? So, this will be the or the downward movement of the line of sight. This is still 2.5 meter, but ito na yung hinahanap natin. Tawagin ko na lang siya as y. So, this is 2.5 minus y, no? Itong tutok na to. So, yung true, para siguro hindi kayo malito, ilagay ko na lang dito. So, ayan. No? Ang hinahanap natin ngayon is the correct reading y, no? Or the reading of the instrument, no? So, yun again, bumaba siya. Kasi nga, nag-move siya ng 3 spaces to the right. So, question, sir, is it established na kapag yung bubble is nag-move to the right, automatic upward siya, and kapag nag-move to the left, automatic leftward siya? No. That is coincidence lang in this problem, no? Coincidence lang siya. Kasi nakalagay kasi dito sa unang part ng situation, nung nag-move siya sa right, tumaas siya. Okay, but that can be not true to other situation, no? So pwedeng yung pagtaas is when the bubble moves to the left. Okay, no? So I hope this problem will not cause confusion, no? Nagkataon lang sa problem na to, class, na when the bubble moves to the right, the reading is upward. So, dapat to the left is downward. But, there are some cases na yung leftward na pag-move ng bubble causes the instrument to move up and right, of course, yung pagbaba. Okay? So, this is just a coincidence lang. Sige? Gayunman, na-establish na nga natin na kapag ano, to the left nga is bababa siya based nga sa opposite lang nung original na nangyari nung pakanan. So, here, hanapin ko lang dito yung theta. Di ba nga, yung ating alpha is equal to theta over the number of spaces. Okay? So, using this formula, we can say na yung theta ay 0 degree, 0 minute, 33 seconds, multiplied natin ng tatlong spaces. Dahil our instrument or our bubble moves 3 spaces to the left. So, 0 degree, I forgot to use my calculator. 0 degree, 0 minute, 33 seconds, times 3. So, that is 0 degree, 1 minute, 39 seconds, no? The next thing to do is just using the triangle. Siguro, let me draw the triangle para wala pa rin confusion. Hindi malito. The distance naman between the rod instrument and the rod or the leveling rod is 100 meters. So, ito na yung 2.5 minus y. And this is now our theta. So, therefore, we can say na tangent ng 0 degree, 1 minute, 39 seconds is equal to 2.5 minus y over 100. So, the new or the reading na mangyayari will be equal to, so parang 100 tangent 0, 1, 39, then yun na lang. So, parang 2.5 minus ans. So, 2.452 meters. So, ito yung ina-expect natin na reading kapag nag-move yung bubble 3 spaces to the left. So, di ba? The concept of bubble sensitivity is very easy lang naman, class. And I hope naintindihan nyo siya dito sa problem natin. So, thank you so much for listening and ingat sa lahat.